Welcome to the Texas Sports Monthly Friday Night Countdown, presented by the ABC Home and Commercial Services High School Football Network. Also brought to you by American Water Connecticut, Factory Mattress, Round Rock Honda, Round Rock Hyundai, Round Rock Toyota, RV Outlet Mall, Dr. Greg Eckert, Austin Billiards, Qualtech Automotive, Paul's Motor Works, Sharp Vision Modern LASIK, Capital Chevrolet, Urology Austin, Whataburger, Thrivin' Financial, Vandegrift High School, Inner Space Cavern, Thomas J. Henry, Mack Hike Ford Lincoln, Total Men's, UFCU, Central Texas Honda Dealers, and Tires to You. Now, here's your host, Russell Dowden.
All right, welcome to the Friday Night Countdown. It is big time football weekend this weekend here on Friday Night Countdown and 104.9 The Horn. The 25-6A championship is at stake tonight with Westlake coming into Lake Travis. Steve, how are you? Big football game tonight all around Central Texas.
It's on tonight, Russell. It is on, man. I am excited for this game. Westlake, Lake Travis. Just a little, you know, a little background on this rivalry, you know, Battle of the Lakes. These are the two prides of the city as far as football is concerned. Westlake is the old school pride. Lake Travis kind of took the new school pride of the hills. This is an interesting game. You know, this is a rivalry that, and the thing with this rivalry is Lake Travis dominated this thing for a solid decade.
They really did. And then we just saw a change. And you mentioned just before that we went on air here, they've won 10 times in a 9-year stretch.
They won 10 times in a 9-year span. And what happens is when a rivalry gets that one-sided, it almost ceases being a rivalry. You know, like you got to have some competition, all right? And so it was almost starting to become a joke among Lake Travis people, this Westlake Lake Travis thing. I actually worked with some Lake Travis people a couple years ago before Westlake ended the streak, and they were all messing with me, man. They were all every day, you know. But then 2 years ago, Lake Travis ended the streak. 21-14 game down the road at Chaparral Stadium. A really good game. Ended on a close ball spot in the fourth quarter. And it was a big one for Westlake. Huge one for the program. Huge one for the community. But I think for a lot of people, there was still a question of how real it was. You know what I mean? Like when it's your first win in 10 tries, you know? Was it a fluke? Even myself. I'm a Westlake kid, you know? I don't know. You know?
Are you doing a flashback?
I'm not going to go to the time machine.
No time machine tonight. All right, no Westlake time machine for Steve.
But then last year they proved it. 44-14 beat down, and now tonight it's on tonight, Russell.
Well, this week there, of course, this year, this game being held there at Cavalier Stadium in Lake Travis. So I think that might make a little more of an evenly matchup. Both teams very good coming into this game. Again, like we said, it's the winner of this game essentially will win that district in all odds. You know, most likely it has been the trend that the winner of this game wins the district title.
These two teams are another level. I mean, there's only a few teams in Austin that have a chance of winning state. You know, that really have a legit shot at doing that. And these are two of those teams.
Well, I want to remind our listeners to follow us on Facebook at Texas Sports Monthly and Twitter at TX Sports Monthly, or on Instagram there at Texas Sports Monthly as well. Later here on the Whip Around, the games tonight. The big one here with Mark and Bucky, Lake Travis, hosting Westlake, Austin High at Hayes, Vandegrift at McNeil, and Glenn at Cedar Creek. Those all can be heard here on the Horn or the Horn app. In fact, I guess we could go over and see. Let's see. Austin and Hayes is on 105 The Bat with the webcast, the IHS Fan Webcast Network. Leander at Round Rock, that's also on the IHS Fan Webcast Network. And then we've got a Vandegrift at McNeil, which you can hear on 101.9 and AM 1260, as well as the IHS Fan Webcast, because you can hear that crew doing it from McNeil, and then you got the normal guys over there with the Vandegrift. So, and then they got this week on the app is Cedar Creek at Glenn, IHS Fan Webcast Network. All be heard on hornfm.com. Guys, if you haven't gotten the app, pick that up because you can hear great football. I've checked it out. What's cool is when you're driving to another game,
yeah,
you can you know, you can't pick up the game in the station, but you can, you know, you can just, all of it, we all got Bluetooth on our phone and our cars, so, you know, you can just throw that app on, and then you can play, you know, the McNeil game for a little while. I tuned into that Round Rock matchup last week.
That was a
good
game.
That was
a great game.
Yeah, it was.
Oh, man. Got a hand to Round Rock. They gave Vandegrift a good run last week.
They really
did.
They're
for real. They're for real.
That game was a lot closer than I thought it was going to be, and then Vandegrift sustained that last drive and that final push.
Well, we were talking going to that game last week how Vandegrift takes all these outstanding offenses and makes them look really average. But they didn't do that to Round Rock. Round Rock just has too many weapons. And Vandegrift in that game, they kept Round Rock from hitting the big play on them. But in an effort to not let Round Rock hit the big play, they were just letting them run up the middle, you know, with Israel Morgan. And that's the thing with the Dragons. They got a lot of guys that can beat you on offense.
Well, the Vipers doing very well as expected this year. Tonight they'll be at McNeil. But, yeah, good stuff, though, from Round Rock.
Yeah, great stuff. And Vandegrift, of course, still won the game. I mean, they got the job done. They got the two stops in the fourth quarter. The offense was able to make enough big plays. Drew Dawson had a very nice game for them at quarterback. That was a breakout game for him.
It was, and they were trailing in the fourth quarter, 25-24 or something like that?
Yeah, just by a point, yeah.
And Round Rock had the lead for a little bit there.
They did.
I was kind of wondering if they were going to hold that through.
Yeah, Round Rock's legit, man. You know, every other team that's gone against Vandegrift, it was like you saw Vandegrift take him down, and you're like, oh, pretender. But Round Rock is legit. I actually kept them number 6 in my rankings this year. I didn't drop them because of how well they played Vandegrift last week. I mean, they have a chance to make a deep playoff run this year. They proved that.
Yeah, I think they will do a deep run. Round Rock Dragons looking very good. A couple announcements here. Just wanted to make announcements on one of our sponsors is Jason's Deli over there in Lake Travis. This weekend, guys, all you guys out in the LT area tuning in, if you go to the Jason's Deli in Lake Travis and get an entree, purchase anything for dinner, he's just doing free tea all weekend. So if we're over there later tonight after the game, you can go get something to eat at your Jason's Deli there in Lake Travis. Go by there and see Scott and the guys, and they'll hook you up with free beverages this weekend. That's going on all weekend, too, as well.
And you're always going to get that soft serve ice cream there, too.
Take advantage of the soft serve.
So you get free tea and free soft serve ice cream.
So go check out our friends at Jason's Deli all weekend long. You get free tea out there. So enjoy that stuff. And also free appetizers while you go to a UT game at Mr. Tramps up in North Austin. A lot of folks I know are up in North Austin tuning in. Mr. Tramps is a really great sports bar up there. One of our sponsors here on the show, but Brandon and I were talking the other day, and he's, you know, let your listeners know, Russell, that when they come in for Texas game, wearing a UT hat, wearing burnt orange, you know, one, as long as it's one or two more than two people, you come in, you get free buffalo wings, free appetizers, mozzarella sticks, whatever you want to do. You like the quesadillas, you get the free appetizer when you go see a Texas game at Mr. Tramps. So if you're up there in the North Austin area, you want to take advantage, don't know where you're watching the game tomorrow, check out our friends over there at Mr. Tramps on Fairfield and 183. All right, we'll do whip around here shortly, and then we'll cover some of this big game tonight. That's our TexasHSFootball.com game of the week is obviously the Battle of the Lakes with Lake Travis and Westlake. We will cover our coach's corner. It's going to be Coach Carter.
Got Big Hank. Big Hank.
And that is our What's for Lunch Coach's Corner with Hank Carter. And then I did the Sendero Homes Player of the Week, which is Hudson Card.
And I got to say, you did a good job with that, man. I was proud of you, man.
I didn't do a bad job of that. That was my best Steve Ryan impersonation.
You literally asked the three questions I totally would have asked. I was amazed. It was like, that's literally what I would have done.
Well, we will do the Coach's Corner and the Player of the Week. Hudson Card made the cover of Texas Sports Monthly that's out in all HEBs and Randalls here in Central Texas. And pick up a copy of that new issue of Texas Sports Monthly, Hudson Card. Good stuff as we continue the Friday Night Countdown. We'll do the whip around with Kit McConico and the rest of the guys. Brought to you by Howdy Honda right after this. It's 104.9 AM 1260. We'll be right back. See to the dark blue sky.
TexasHSFootball.com. Proud to sponsor the Friday Night Countdown. Log on for the latest in game coverage, scores, team pages, player profiles, and Texas recruiting news. That's TexasHSFootball.com. For all things high school football, TexasHSFootball.com.
Horns fans, Mr. Tramp Sports Pub invites all Longhorns fans to the game every Saturday. Get a free appetizer during the game when wearing Horns gear. When three or more Horns fans show up to Mr. Tramp's to watch the game, receive free wings or any appetizer. Mr. Tramp's with great food, huge screens with sound, daily drink specials, and the best happy hour in North Austin. Mr. Tramp Sports Pub, your headquarters for college football this season. 183 at Fairfield Lane, where North Austin goes for sports. MrTramps.com.
Mr. Tramp's.
NXG Recruiting, now accepting new memberships in their elite sports training facility in Lake Travis. Train with former Longhorn Mike Davis. Speed and agility, strength and conditioning, hitting and pitching instruction, and create your own video performance profile for recruiters. Train your student athlete this fall with NXG Recruiting, taking the next generation to the next level. Located on Debit Drive near 620 or visit online at nxgrecruiting.com. Jason's Deli has something great for everyone. Fan favorites are the Garden Fresh Salad Bar, Reuben and Deli Cowboy. Feeding school spirit, it's a family thing at Jason's Deli Lakeway. Open every day right down the street from Lake Travis High School.
What's for Lunch is a full-service catering company specializing in family-style lunches for businesses in the Austin area. Catering breakfast, lunch, dinner, and afternoon snacks for special events, training seminars, tailgate parties, conferences, birthdays, celebrations, cocktail parties, local businesses, South by Southwest day parties, private parties, sports banquets, and much more. Think outside the lunchbox when you ask yourself, what's for lunch? That's What's for Lunch Corporate Catering. Call them today at 512-388-6062. That's 388-6062, or place your order online at whatsforlunchaustin.com.
When you do whatever it takes to get the job done, they say you're on it. At ASCO Equipment, we are on it. It's what we learned as kids, what our parents taught us, to work hard, get the job done, and get it done right. We partnered with Case Construction Equipment because they get the job done, too. You can buy and rent Case equipment from us, and we'll service and support it, just like we support you, because we're on it. Whatever it is, at ASCO, we're on it.
Hey, it's Aaron Hogan. You can buy your new Ford car, truck, or SUV anywhere. There's a lot of options, but there's only one place where you can go to experience the Covert difference, and that's Covert Ford of Austin on 183. The Covers have been selling vehicles to Central Texas car buyers for over 110 years, and they're still family-owned and operated. And at Covert Ford of Austin, they'll treat you like family. How about the amazing fall savings they're offering right now at Covert Ford of Austin? How about no-interest financing for 72 months available on all new 2019 Ford Expeditions? Up to $16,000 off the MSRP on the new 2019 Ford F-150s? How about no-interest financing for 72 months available on all remaining 2019 Ford Flexes? They got the 2019 Ford Rangers for no interest financing for 60 months right now. Oh, and they've got the new 2020 Ford Explorer on the lot, completely redesigned inside and out. You've got to check out that vehicle. It's Covert Ford of Austin, online at covertford.com. Nobody meets the Covert Ford deal. Not now, not ever.
See dealer for complete details, and all rebates are compatible with offers mentioned. Incentives and discounts may vary. Conditional discounts may apply, plus TT&L and dealer fees. WIC with Ford credit, and all buyers will qualify. Offer expires 10/31/19.
Folks, let's talk about your tank water heater. With too many folks in the house using all that hot water, it simply can't produce enough. And it probably hits about the time you're ready to take a shower, right? Here's a suggestion. A tankless water heater from ABC Home and Commercial Services and Rheem. With an incredible Rheem tankless unit, you get endless hot water with the latest technology. It's instant hot water, as much as you need. For additional information and free estimates, you know who to call. ABC Home and Commercial Services, specialist for your environment. License number M32147.
Like sports, business is about winning. Championship decisions are business decisions based on what it takes to help your company win. And that's why there's UBO Business Services, specializing in helping you win every day by streamlining workflow and allowing you to better communicate within your organization and with your customers. Make your championship decision with UBO Business Services. Visit them at ubeo.com. Great people, great service, endless possibilities.
The Friday Football Countdown Central Texas High School Football Whip Around is powered by Howdy Honda, your low price, express purchase, friendly home for Honda. Remember to join me, Kit McConico, at halftime and postgame for all of your high school football coverage here on the Horn.
I'm Mark Honig at Cavalier Stadium. It's the one we've all been waiting for, not the Red River Showdown. This one over another body of water, the Battle of the Lakes, Lake Travis against Westlake. This rivalry was one-sided in favor of Lake Travis. The Cavs won 10 straight. However, the last 2 years, the Chaparrals have won, including last year's 44-14 drubbing in Westlake. Both offenses average at least 460 yards per game and at least 295 yards passing. LT relies on UT commit Hudson Carr, while the Shaps have used three QBs all season: Kirkland Michaud, Drew Willoughby, and sophomore Cade Klubnik. Lots of firepower on each side, which means the defense that steps up will probably get the win. Steve Foster joins me for the call at 7:30. Now let's head down to Hays County.
Rodney Rodriguez from Bob Shelton Stadium in Buda. Austin High looks to rebound from a tough loss last week to Del Valle. The task will be just as tough as the Maroons take on an undefeated Hays Rebel team averaging 369 yards on the ground with that vaunted slot T offense. Austin High will look to get a quick start in this crucial 25-6A contest. The playoff picture is starting to shape up, and both of these teams look to be a part of it. For Austin High, this is a crucial game to keep those hopes alive. This will be a great game on a chilly evening in Hays County. We'll have it at 7:30 on 105.3 The Bat FM and the Horn Webcast Network, powered by IHS Fan.
This is Merle Bertrand from the Kelly Reeves Athletic Center, where for the first time in 3 weeks, the Vandegrift Vipers will not be locked in a battle of unbeatens when they take on McNeil. But while the Vipers may be the favorite, no one gave that memo to the Mavericks, who will give the Vipers their best shot. It's the Vandegrift Vipers against the McNeil Mavericks, coming up on the Horn, 101.9 FM and AM 1260.
Alan Cepeda reporting from a very cold Bible Stadium in Leander for tonight's matchup between Cedar Creek and Glenn. Both teams are 1-1 in the district and can separate themselves with a win tonight. Glenn will look to reestablish their offense after they were shut out last week 42-0 against Weiss. Expect a heavy dose of running back Julian Morris. Cedar Creek will be led by their defense and Alfred Collins, which has already produced 5 touchdowns on the season. The weather has dropped and fall football is here. Kickoff is scheduled for 7 p.m. on the all-new Horn Webcast Network. Download the app today.
It's the Central Texas High School Whip Around, brought to you by Howdy Honda, your low price, express purchase, friendly home for Honda.
All right, there you go. The whip around there with Kit. And the guys brought to you by Howdy Honda. That just gives you every week a look at all of the commercial services, home, high school football radio network games, and the IHS Fan Webcast Network. So check those games out, guys, and tune in. We've got a good one tonight, Steve. Our coach's corner is up next, is it?
Yeah, Big Hank. Let's shoot it.
It's the Coach's Corner.
This week on the What's for Lunch Catering Coach's Corner, we got Hank Carter of Lake Travis. Coach, you've been a part of this rivalry for a long time. What does this game personally mean to you, and how would you stack it up with other rivalries you've played or coached in the past?
Well, you know, obviously this week always is it's a really exciting time for our community, our school, our players, our student body. You know, we have so much respect for Westlake, and they've been such a great program for a long time, and Coach Dodge and his team are always, you know, they're always top caliber as far as it is in the state of Texas. So it's a great opportunity for us to test ourselves and to go against another great opponent. But it's also a unique rivalry in the fact that, you know, our schools are so close in proximity. We've got players at college and pro level, you know, that are prominent figures, and you know, both. And those guys talk about, you know, where they went to high school a lot. Obviously, sometimes Baker still brings that stuff up. But, you know, for me, I've been a part of, obviously, this rivalry now going on 12 years. I was at Stephenville for the Stephenville-Brownwood rivalry, and that was a very heated, pretty nasty one. And then going back early in my career, Bay City, when I coached at Bay City, the Ricebirds from El Campo were our rivals. So, you know, this one, you know, to me, this one, because both schools are 6A and both schools have are really, you know, having a ton of success at the same time. To me, this is about as sweet as it gets. And, you know, we'll be playing in front of a sold-out stadium at Cavalier Stadium on Friday night, and we're just looking forward to it.
Westlake has 3 quarterbacks that they've been rotating on offense. Have you ever been in the situation where you had to prepare for 3 quarterbacks before, and how has the game planning process changed because of that?
Yeah, that's a good point. I'm not sure if I can remember having to prepare for 3, but we have prepared for multiple quarterbacks, you know, several times. It presents some challenges. What I will say that's unique about this is the offense doesn't change a great deal depending on who's in. They tend to pretty much run the offense the same way, whichever the 3 guys are in there, and all 3 of them are great players. And, you know, so obviously that'll be a tough challenge for our guys. And, And, you know, we're going to have to make sure that we're prepared for that.
Well, that's all I got, Coach. Thanks for your time and good luck on Friday.
You bet. Thank you.
It's the Coach's Corner, brought to you by What's for Lunch.
All right, there's our What's for Lunch catering Coach's Corner. Good one there with Hank Carter. A lot of respect, Steve, for both Coach Carter, from Coach Carter and Dodge for one another.
Yeah, it's funny. I did the Coach's Corner with Hank Carter this week, and I ran into Todd Dodge at Academy today.
Oh, did you?
I really did. I was at Academy. Hey. Hey, what's up, Coach? What are you doing? I'm buying a 9-iron. but yeah, going to be a great game. The TexasHSFootball.com Game of the Week. I can't wait. Westlake coming in 5-0, and they are straight killing people right now. I mean, this team, this Westlake team, they're dangerous, man.
I think they're one of the best teams in Central Texas to go the furthest this year and make the run on that playoff push as we get into November.
They've been knocking on the door to win that second state title for a long time now. I mean, the last 4 years, they've been right. I mean, first of all, they've been to state 5 times since they won in 96, lost all 5 state championships. I mean, look at the last 4 years. 4 years ago, they go to the state title game. They lost to Galena Park North Shore in overtime. 3 years ago, had a great team. Sam Ellinger gets hurt in the playoffs, loses Lake Travis in the fourth round. 2 years ago, they had another great team, made the state semis. One of those games, they just didn't play their A game, had 3 turnovers, lost to a very good Cy Fair team, 14-10. And then last year, again, injuries. You get their quarterback, their running back, their starting center all go down. But this year, man, things are lining up this year for the Chaps, man. The defense is astounding. And just look at the scores, the way they're killing people this year. You look at their two non-district opponents. Belton, they beat 38-17 last year. This year, they beat them 48-0, all right? Cy Ranch, they lost 25-21 last year. This year, they beat them 35-7 on the road. I mean, they are on another level, and it starts with that D. I mean, they're good on both sides of the ball, but you got to start with the defense. They have this new tradition of having great defensive lines. Wish they had that when I was there. I mean, when I was there, we could score points but couldn't stop a nosebleed. You know, the last 2 years, it was Braden Cassidy and David Neal, who both went on to FBS programs after graduating. And this year, they got Bobby Dumpkin and Austin McClendon, Dumpkin at 6'5", 230. Yeah. Nice list of FCS offers. Also, Army, he has a team-leading 8 quarterback hurries and a pick six. And then McClendon at 6'3", 235, has 5 sacks, including a safety. The last 2 years, they've really won this game with that defensive line, being able to get pressure on the Lake Travis quarterbacks without them having to blitz. You know, they can just rush 3 or 4, let everyone else drop back. I mean, that's always the best kind of defense.
Well, I think that's going to be, we're going to see how much Hudson Card is under duress from the front four and that Westlake outstanding defense that Westlake has as they come into Lake Travis for this one.
Yeah, that'll be different. Although I've always said, I don't think home field advantage really means that much at the high school football level. It just doesn't. I'm sorry. If you don't have to travel, if you don't have like a giant, you know, Westlake's going to have a lot of fans there. It's not like it's going to be.
I think the Cavs fans differ.
Yeah, that opinion. You think so? Well, they're going to be angry. They're going to be fired up, man.
For a win. They want to get back on top of this thing as the Cav fan nation having fallen to Westlake the last 2 years. So they certainly want to get on the big top side of that rivalry this year. But I mean, that trio of quarterbacks with its Klubnik, Willoughby, Michaud, that's. How do you ask that to Coach Carter? Yeah. How do you prepare for 3 quarterbacks? That's odd.
It's an interesting setup. It's something I've never really seen. I mean, a 3-quarterback system by a team that has a chance to win state. And Todd Dodge has said it himself. He's always been a 1-quarterback guy.
Yeah.
And this year he's decided to go outside the box.
Well,
and,
you know, I heard Coach Dodge's interview last week with Craig in the morning show on Craig's show morning, and he does the interview with both Carter and Dodge every week, but. You know, Dodge spoke to Craig saying, you know, when he started off in late August, he wasn't sure who was going to get this job. And here we are in week 7. He's just playing all 3 of them.
Hey, so it's working.
It's working for him, and we'll see how well it exactly works for him tonight in Lake Travis. We'll be back with more Friday Night Countdown after this. It's the Battle of the Lakes week right here on 104.9 The Horn.
Solid Decorative Coatings is a proud sponsor of Central Texas High School football, specializing in outdoor living, gazebos, and patios for your home or business. Turn to the pros at Rock Solid. Rock Solid specializes in repairing your concrete project or flooring system from damage. Your team needs a Rock Solid defense to win championships, so why not call the winning professionals at Rock Solid Decorative Coatings today, 512-244-3612, or visit them online at TexasRockSolidCoatings.com. Texas Sports Monthly September edition is available at all HEBs and Randalls, featuring Sam Ellinger and the Texas Longhorns on the cover. Don't miss all the action covering the Big 12, the Dallas Cowboys and the Houston Texans. High schools profiled are Hutto, Cedar Park, Lake Travis, Westlake, and Vandegrift. And listen to our show, The Friday Night Countdown, here on 104.9 The Horn, 6:30 to 7:15 every Friday night. Texas Sports Monthly. All sports, all Texas, all month.
Jason's Deli has something great for everyone. Fan favorites are the Garden Fresh Salad Bar, Reuben and Deli Cowboy. Feeding school spirit, it's a family thing at Jason's Deli Lakeway. Open every day right down the street from Lake Travis High School.
Sendero Homes, a proud sponsor of high school football in Austin, Westlake, and Lakeway for a quarter of a century. Texas Ranch Homes, Italian-style villas, cutting-edge contemporaries, and all the transitional blends in between. For unique custom homes, turn to the pros at Sendero Homes. SenderoHomes.com.
What's for Lunch is a full-service catering company specializing in family-style lunches for businesses in the Austin area. Catering breakfast, lunch, dinner, and afternoon snacks for special events, training seminars, tailgate parties, conferences, birthdays, celebrations, cocktail parties, local businesses, South by Southwest day parties, private parties, sports banquets, and much more. Think outside the lunchbox when you ask yourself, what's for lunch? That's What's for Lunch Corporate Catering. Call them today at 512-388-6062. That's 388-6062. Or place your order online at whatsforlunchaustin.com.
Texas, welcome to Save Yourself with Geico.
You go in for a hug, but the huggee pulls up for a handshake. You couldn't save yourself from the crushing inner cringe of a handshake-hug mix-up. But you could save yourself hundreds by switching your car insurance to Geico.
Yes.
You could save on motorcycle, boat, and RV insurance, too.
Nice.
Plus, the Geico Insurance Agency could help you save on homeowners and renters insurance.
Oh.
While your dopey arms, extended like a wounded bird, have become your biggest problem, you should know Geico is the second largest auto insurer in the country.
Okay.
Geico even offers 24/7 access to licensed agents and emergency roadside service.
Huh.
And while hugs don't always go as expected, you could expect your local Geico agent to help you save even more.
Ooh.
Like with federal and military discounts.
You couldn't save yourself the embarrassment of a handshake hug, but you could save yourself hundreds with Geico online, over the phone, or at your local office.
Bowling, 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 bowling.
Every day is a great day at your Greater Austin Bowling Centers.
Dart Bowl, Highland Lanes, and Westgate Lanes are the perfect place for great family fun any day of the week.
Birthday parties, holiday parties, work events, any kind of gathering is an instant blast at the lanes. Bowling at Dart Bowl, Highland Lanes, and Westgate Lanes is fun for everyone. Even the smallest kids will love bumper bowling, where no gutter ball means pins fall every time.
Any day and any occasion is better with bowling.
No time to spare. Strike out for your Greater Austin Bowling Centers. Austin owned and operated. Dart Bowl, one half block south of 2222 on Grover Avenue near North Lamar and Canaan. And Highland Lanes on Vernon Road just south of 183. And in South Austin, Westgate Lanes at William Cannon and Westgate. Call ahead for lane availability, then grab your friends and the whole family and head for a great time at your Greater Austin Bowling Centers.
Bowling, bowling, bowling.
During Stan's year-end clearance sale, you can save up to $4,086 on Carrier's top-of-the-line variable speed system. It's Stan's lowest price of the year on the best system money can buy, with variable speed cooling, allergy-relieving air cleaner, and smartphone-compatible Wi-Fi thermostat. If you don't need a new system, look online at stansac.com for service discounts on any brand. Turn to the experts, Stan's.
92993.
License 38119E.
BK here for Paul's Motorworks, the premier foreign and domestic automotive repair shop in Central Texas. Paul has 40 years of automotive repair experience under his belt, and he and the crew at PMW are there to help with any car maintenance you may need. Their team of technicians has expert diagnostic skills and can save you both time and money. Paul's Motorworks is a big supporter of area high school athletics. If you mention this ad, receive 10% off your first visit. It's Paul's Motorworks, across the street from Vandegrift High School, 620 and 2222.
Services.
From the UBO Business Services Studios, you're listening to KTXX-FM and HD1 BK. KTAE-AM Elgin. K270CO Round Rock. Back to the Texas Sports Monthly Friday Night Countdown, presented by the ABC Home and Commercial Services High School Football Network.
All right, welcome back to the Friday Night Countdown as Rivalry Week rolls on. It's the big Texas OU weekend here tomorrow with the big game. All things kicking off here, I believe, at 9 a.m. The guys get started on the broadcast tomorrow. So big stuff from Dallas, and the Red River Rivalry continues on a big game there tomorrow, heard right here on the Horn with Craig Way and the guys. So look forward to that. But we still got a big one to play tonight here on the Horn with Battle of the Lakes. So get ready for that one. And let's go ahead and jump to my my player of the week. That's going to be the Sendero Homes player of the week. And I did a brief little interview there with Hudson Card in your place. Normally you do
yeah.
that. Normally you do that one. But no, I went out there and got to speak with Hudson. Real nice young man. And look forward to having him on the cover as a Longhorn eventually one day.
Yes. Yes.
So let's do. Let's go ahead and run to that and go to the player of the week.
Time for Texas Sports Monthly's Player of the Week.
All right, welcome to the Sendero Homes Player of the Week. This week we got Hudson Card of Lake Travis. Hudson, this week you have district rivals Westlake here at home. What do you think about this rivalry, having been a part of this game already for a few years now? And how do you prepare yourself mentally, since the game itself is likely the winner mm-hmm. of that district championship?
I mean, that's what makes it so fun and the rivalry is so special. I mean, it's been going on for years. And both programs are really good and have developed a lot of players, so it just makes it even more special. But, I mean, they're a great team, and we're going to have to come out here and execute like we have in the past. And if we do so, then we should be all right.
Well, you know, Hudson, this team this year has been averaging 52.4 points per game since that loss to Arlington Martin in the season opener. How has the team improved since week one, and what are some of the takeaways that this team has learned since that loss?
I mean, week one was a wake-up call for us. Mm-hmm. I mean, definitely got a little chip on her shoulder and gave us some motivation. So, I mean, just trying to improve week by week, and we have done that so far. So, I mean, again, just try to play a little better this week.
Sounds good. You know, Westlake has a strong defense mm-hmm. and an opposing front four on their line. What do you like about the challenge this week, and what do the Cavs need to do to get back on top of this rivalry and come away with a win this week?
I mean, they're a good team. Again, just trust our coaches. I mean, they put us in a good spot and set us up to win. So, just trust your training, play hard, play physical, and playing tougher than the other opponent will ultimately get you where you want to get.
Well, listen, Hudson, that's all I got for this week. Good luck Friday night, my friend.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
The Friday Night Countdown Player of the Week, brought to you by Sendero Homes.
All right, good stuff from the very talented Hudson Card there, leading his team in a big win tonight there in Lake Travis.
Yeah, quite the athlete. He's got to have a big game. He's got to have a big game. And he's got to do it with both his arm and his legs, I think, which he's capable of doing. I mean, this guy's a sophomore, was the second leading receiver for the Lake Travis Cavaliers. So he's got some athletic ability, but he's going to have to do a lot, because I think that Westlake defensive line, they're really going to be coming after him, man. I actually have a colleague who has scouted both these teams, and I asked him about it this week, and he thinks Westlake's going to win, and he said he thinks that Westlake defensive line is going to have to get after Lake Travis again.
Well, he's going to have to use his legs after that with that defense that they're bringing in to Lake Travis from Westlake.
How are you feeling about this game? What are your?
Well, you think, how many years in a row can Westlake keep winning?
Yeah.
You know, after it was such a lopsided rivalry for so many years with advantage to the Cavaliers. But
do you think Westlake's in Lake Travis's head at all now with two straight wins? Because I think for a while there, Lake Travis was in Westlake's head. And I remember talking to Todd Dodge years ago.
Oh, yeah,
like,
I agree.
Man, we play great every week, and then we play against Lake Travis, and we make all these mistakes. It's like when I used to play my brother at Risk growing up, and he would always beat me at Risk. And it got to the point where when we started the game, he already had me beat, you know? And I think that was a problem for Westlake towards the end of that streak. But now it's been flipped, and they kicked Lake Travis's butt last year, man. Yeah, and that was a resounding win.
I don't think that, you know, I don't know. It's going to be a closer game, I think, this year than that one last year. I think you're right about getting that monkey off your back. Once it's on, it's you got to get that thing off. And Dodge been able to have some success the last few seasons, and we'll see what happens.
We were talking about that Westlake three quarterback system they got going right now. Big reason why that's working, though, is because they have so much depth at wide receiver. I mean, that wide receiver room they got in Westlake right now is really something else. Starts with Mason Mangum. He was the guy that everyone knew was going to be a great player this year. Arkansas commit. He's actually the all-time receiving yards leader in Westlake history now. He broke that record earlier this year. But the best receiver or the leading receiver has surprisingly been Ryan Lindley, a transfer from Westwood. He sat out last year because he was ruled ineligible by UIL, but he has 32 catches for 453 yards and 11 touchdowns this year. Little slot guy, really fast, great at getting open. He was an all-district player at Westwood 2 years ago, but then you got Mangum, who's going to Arkansas. He's got 23 catches for 367, four touchdowns. You got a freshman named Jordan Greathouse. Watch out for this guy going forward. He's 6'3", 200, has 16 grabs, 318, two touchdowns. Looks nothing like a freshman. Looks nothing like a freshman. And then junior Luke Niklos, who has 11 catches for 178 and two touchdowns. I am a little concerned about Westlake's run game. The last 2 years, the big reason they were able to win is because they had those punishing runners. Nakia Watson 2 years ago.
That's right.
Trip Graham last year. This year, they don't really have a bell cow back to lean on, punish defenses, keep Lake Travis's offense off the field. They kind of got a committee, and they're still, they don't have one back with more than 200 yards in
what
the
season.
What
do you have on Lake Travis's offense?
Well, you know, besides Hudson Card, his top receiver is Kyle Eaves, who he's caught 40 balls for 716 yards and six touchdowns. Grayson Sandlin, tight end, has 22 for 422, seven touchdowns. No other player with 10 or more catches after that, though. So those are their two guys. Where Westlake has a bevy of guys that they can attack.
They'll spread around
Lake Travis
a little more.
Really just has those two guys. In the run game, they got a three-headed monster at running back. Marco Alanis has 375 yards, seven touchdowns. Weston Stevens, 222 and four touchdowns. Gary Gordon with 184 and one touchdown.
So where they're spreading it around in the running game, Westlake spreading it around in the passing game.
And here's another thing. I told you, I got a buddy. He's scouted both these teams. I asked him, I asked him about Lake Travis's defense. He goes, they're good. I mean, they're really good, but they're not as great as like some of the state champion defenses they had. Mm-hmm. And I go, what about that secondary? He said one word. You know what he said?
What?
Vulnerable.
Vulnerable. Well, we'll see.
Vulnerable against a deep Westlake receiving core, man. So I don't know, man. I think Westlake may win by a lot, actually. But the other thing to look out for in this game, look out for the trick plays. I mean, last year you had Westlake run a fake punt and a double pass. You had Lake Travis run a flea flicker. Both coaches, they save stuff. They save a lot of stuff for this game.
This is the game that they're going to pull out the rabbit out of the hat. And you're absolutely right about that. I think that both coaches will get a little creative. You may see some.
You're going to see some stuff, man. You're going to see some stuff.
You're going to see some things you don't see every week.
Yeah, don't go get popcorn while the game's going on. You know, wait till there's a break. Run down there, get it real quick, come back, because you might miss something. But, man, it's going to be a great game.
All right, let's do a fourth and long.
Fourth and long. Okay, yeah, sure. Cue it up.
Fourth and long.
All right, you know, we don't do fourth and long every week, Steve, but that's just where we do like a college pick. I'm going to take Florida over LSU.
For your upset, nice.
That's my upset pick for this week.
I think LSU is going to win by 40. I'm just telling you right now, I really do. I think that's going to be a game. My upset pick, I'm going Michigan State over Wisconsin. I think Michigan State's defense,
they're
going to slow down Wisconsin's run game a little, make them beat them with Jack Cohen, who showed against Northwestern that he can't exactly carry a team on his back. I mean, Wisconsin won that game. They needed two defensive touchdowns to beat Northwestern. They're not going to get that against the Spartans. I think Michigan State goes into Madison. Big upset over the Badgers.
Will the Longhorns beat Oklahoma?
I'm afraid not. I hate to break all the Texas fans out there, but OU runs the Big 12, man.
I'm rooting for the Longhorns as I was always been from here. So I'm going Longhorns. They will cover the spread.
They got a very physical offensive defensive line.
But
I cannot root for...
I have to go Longhorns, even though my gut says it's going to be a close one.
Yeah, it'll be a good game.
All right, there's your Friday night countdown, guys. Stick around. We've got a good night of football right here on 104.9 The Horn. It's the Battle of the Lakes right up after this.
Thank you for listening to the Texas Sports Monthly Friday Night Countdown. Presented by the ABC Home and Commercial Services High School Football Network.
also brought to you by American Water Connecticut, Factory Mattress, Round Rock Honda, Round Rock Hyundai, Round Rock Toyota, RV Outlet Mall, Dr. Greg Eckert, Austin Billiards, Qualtech Automotive, Paul's Motorworks, Sharp Vision Modern LASIK, Capital Chevrolet, Urology Austin, Whataburger, Thrivin' Financial, Vandegrift High School, Inner Space Cavern, Thomas J. Henry, Mack Hike Ford Lincoln, Total Men's, UFCU, Central Texas Honda Dealers, and Tires to You.
Rock Solid Decorative Coatings is a proud sponsor of Central Texas High School football, specializing in outdoor living, gazebos, and patios for your home or business. Turn to the pros at Rock Solid. Rock Solid specializes in repairing your concrete project or flooring system from damage. Your team needs a Rock Solid defense to win championships, so why not call the winning professionals at Rock Solid Decorative Coatings today, 512-244-3612, or visit them online at TexasRockSolidCoatings.com. Texas Sports Monthly September edition is available at all HEBs and Randalls, featuring Sam Ellinger and the Texas Longhorns on the cover. Don't miss all the action covering the Big 12, the Dallas Cowboys and the Houston Texans. High schools profiled are Hutto, Cedar Park, Lake Travis, Westlake, and Vandegrift. And listen to our show, The Friday Night Countdown, here on 104.9 The Horn, 6:30 to 7:15 every Friday night. Texas Sports Monthly, all sports, all Texas, all month.
TexasHSFootball.com. Proud to sponsor the Friday Night Countdown. Log on for the latest in game coverage, scores, team pages, player profiles, and Texas recruiting news. That's TexasHSFootball.com.
For all things high school football, TexasHSFootball.com.
Horns fans, Mr. Tramp Sports Pub invites all Longhorns fans to the game every Saturday. Get a free appetizer during the game when wearing Horns gear. When three or more Horns fans show up to Mr. Tramp's to watch a game, receive free wings or any appetizer. Mr. Tramp's with great food, huge screens with sound, daily drink specials, and the best happy hour in North Austin. Mr. Tramp Sports Pub, your headquarters for college football this season. 183 at Fairfield Lane, where North Austin goes for sports. MrTramps.com.
Mr. Tramp's.
Sendero Homes, a proud sponsor of high school football in Austin, Westlake, and Lakeway for a quarter of a century. Texas Ranch Homes, Italian-style villas, cutting-edge contemporaries, and all the transitional blends in between. For unique custom homes, turn to the pros at Sendero Homes. SenderoHomes.com.
Napa know-how.
Why should you buy a 99-cent Napa bag? Because it's no ordinary bag. It can save you 20% on three or more items you can fit inside. Some call that magic. Others say it's the eighth wonder of the world. But whatever it is, it's the best way to save you 20% on brakes, filters, wipers, and more. Quality parts, helpful people. That's Napa know-how.
Napa know-how.
At participating Napa Auto Parts stores, while supplies last. Minimum three items. Exclusions apply. Offer ends 10/31/19.
It's Mattress Firm Save Big Sale. Save up to $400. Plus, get 0% APR for 6 years, zero down, and zero due at signing. It's as easy as sign, save, sleep. And get a free adjustable base with any purchase of $699. Don't wait. Your budget stretches further at Mattress Firm.
Offer valid with qualifying purchase. Restrictions apply. Call 1-866-780-6220 for credit costs and terms. For new accounts, purchase APR is 29.99%. Subject to credit approval, valid at participating locations only. For offer details, visit mattressfirm.com/sale.
I am that typical girl. If everyone else has it, I don't want it. I want that unique, something special that no one else has.
Deborah Looper dreamed of getting a truly one-of-a-kind engagement ring. And when she found Diamonds Direct, that dream became reality.
It truly is the fairy tale. I pinch myself daily.
Deborah was amazed to learn that Diamonds Direct works directly with the world's top bridal designers who can take an already beautiful ring and customize it just for her.
They took the ring design and said, let's personalize it. I walk out thinking, they are making a ring for me. I am beyond words about that.
And the end result? A spectacular, handcrafted Christopher Designs ring, just the way she dreamed it.
No one else has what I have on my hand.
Diamonds Direct, where the possibilities are truly endless.
It was nothing short of an awesome experience.
Get the ring of your dreams without a compromise at Diamonds Direct.
If you can dream it, Diamonds Direct can design it.
Get directions, store hours, and more at DiamondsDirect.com.
It's football.
football season. You know what that means.
You need a new ride. And the Penske Automotive family has got your number. Right now, Round Rock Honda, Round Rock Toyota, and Round Rock Hyundai have nearly 2,000 new and used vehicles that'll look amazing as you pull into a stadium parking lot with deals that cannot be beat. That's Round Rock Auto Group. Find dealerships like Round Rock Toyota, Exit 254, I-35, and RoundRockToyota.com.
Lake Travis Cavaliers football is on the air. Brought to you by Austin BMW Centers, the A.J. Miller Group, F2 On-Site, Golf Cart Zone, Obsequio Ventures, True Car, Acceleration Sports Performance, Bacon Design, Hill Country Indoor, Lexus of Lakeway, Sky Ridge Dental, Arbogast Homes, Evans Family Law, Firm Space, Jana Birdwell Realtor, Lakeway Vet, LTYA, Moreland Properties, Ramos Consulting, Serene Hills, Sing Orthodontics, Doug Wilkins CPA, Seven Custom Homes, Ranch Road Holdings, Stephen Covey, Austin Lakes Dentistry, Craig O's, Dorsett, Johnson and Swift, Lakeway Orthodontics, Morningstar Mini Storage, Plains Capital, Rudy's Barbecue, Scott Ramsey, The Print Shop, X-Works, and By Wink. Now, here's your Lake Travis Cavaliers broadcast team, Mark Honig and Bucky Godbold.
It's one of the marquee games in the state, the Battle of the Lakes. This wasn't much of a rivalry for nearly a decade. Lake Travis won 10 straight, but the last 2 years, it's been the Chaparrals on top. This game isn't just about bragging rights. It's for the inside track to the district championship. Hi again, everyone, and good evening from chilly Cavalier Stadium. It's the most anticipated game of the year in Central Texas. We finally have some football weather. Mark Honig and Steve Foster in for Bucky Godbold, our good friend. And Foster, this is what it's all about. I mean, you've seen a bunch of these. It's Lake Travis. It's Westlake. The atmosphere is out of control. Place is sold out. This is as good as it gets.
This is literally as good as it gets. And it's our job as media to let people know how good this game is. As you mentioned, dominance by Lake Travis. And now, rightfully so, Coach Dodge and the Chaparrals looking to get back on top.
Both teams very similar. They pass the ball a lot more than they throw the ball, but both teams looking to establish the run. That starts with the offensive line.
Yes, and again, to me, he who wins the line of scrimmage usually has a good inside track, as you like to say, to win this game. Because, again, so much disruption can occur if you don't win the line of scrimmage or at least neutralize the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, and we talked about the offensive line, but let's go to the defensive line. So last year, the Westlake defensive line was awesome in this game, and they were all over Hudson Card. And as a result, they got a big victory. What do you think the key is going to be? Whose defensive line is going to step up in this one?
Well, you know, surveying Lake Travis's defensive line, they are senior-laden, so they have experience. You look across that front four, the idea is to put them in a position to disrupt the timing of Westlake. And Westlake has been very good and consistent, been excellent even, over these first six games. And so, you know, you have to take that senior leadership and commit tonight to saying, if we want to win a district championship, we've got to do it at home, we've got to do it in some adverse weather, and we've got to do it so that the Chaparral offense is disrupted.
Lake Travis and Westlake going at it tonight. The third member of our crew is Stu Myrick, who's down on the field. Stu, you're a little bundled up tonight.
You know, it's nice to actually have some cool weather. I'm going to go full Craig Way on this one. When it comes to water-centric rivalries in football, this weekend we got you covered. Of course, tomorrow, the Red River Showdown with Texas and Oklahoma. Tonight, the Battle of the Lakes with Westlake and Lake Travis. Had a chance to talk with Westlake head coach Todd Dodge. He said, you know, this game is all about testing each other. Two teams equally matched. They, you know, obviously, as you mentioned, it's usually the de facto district championship game, and it's a measuring stick. It's a measuring stick for both teams. He mentioned his three-quarterback system. It's working better than he expected. That's why they're still going with it. The key to tonight, according to Todd Dodge, play great on first down. Get that start on that drive, and that will lead to success later on.
All right, you mentioned that three-quarterback system. Three guys, Kirkland, Michaud, Drew Willoughby and Cade Klubnik, the sophomore, will alternate snaps tonight, sometimes series, sometimes they'll come in between series. It should be a lot of fun to try to keep track of that. When we return, we'll get the thoughts of Westlake head coach Todd Dodge. Then we'll visit with Cavalier head coach Hank Carter. It's the Battle of the Lakes, and our pregame show continues in a moment.
Carter, perhaps looking to build a custom golf cart? Check out the great folks at Golf Cart Zone. Maybe you already have a golf cart and need repairs. I want to customize your cart. Golf Cart Zone is the place to go. New or used, buy or lease, riding on cart paths or through rough terrain. Make sure your search starts and ends with Golf Cart Zone. They even have a pickup and delivery service. Located on Research Boulevard between Spicewood Springs and Anderson Mill, reach them by phone at 512-258-9663 or online at golfcartzone.com. Every football team needs specialists, those players that focus on one area to help the larger team. The same is true in healthcare. As hospitals and clinics struggle to remain profitable, specialists like Obsequio Ventures are providing that extra hand to ensure growth and efficiency. Whether the challenge is compliance, diagnostics, or legal, Obsequio Ventures can help healthcare facilities strategize and succeed. Obsequio is excited to be bringing their services into the Texas market very soon. Obsequio Ventures, a proud supporter of the Lake Travis Cavaliers.
Visit Hill Country Indoors to see why you and your family are better off indoors. HCI offers four hardtop courts, an indoor turf field, batting and pitching cages, multi-theme climb zone area, kid care and youth programs, private fitness center, luxurious locker rooms, indoor track, unlimited studio group classes, as well as a cafe and sports lounge. With so much available, everyone can experience more at Hill Country Indoor, located on Bee Cave Parkway and online at hillcountryindoor.com.
Are you refinancing or buying a home soon? You deserve a true expert to help you with the biggest investment of your life. Call A.J. Miller, your local reputable Lake Travis lender. Visit ajmillergroup.com to apply.
Fairway Independent Mortgage Corporation, NMLS number 2289, is an equal housing lender. This is not an offer to enter into an agreement. Not all customers will qualify. Information, rates, and programs are not subject to change without notice. All products are subject to credit and property approval. A.J. Miller, NMLS number 403782, 1202 Lakeway Drive, Suite 12, Lakeway, Texas.
We welcome you back to Cavalier Stadium as we continue on the pregame show. Westlake head coach Todd Dodge has been watching film all week. And when he takes a look at the Cavaliers, you might be surprised at what jumps out to him.
Their defense, you know, it looks a lot like our defense. You know, they solid defense front, linebacker levels active, and really, really athletic in the back end. And so, and then offensively, it's Hudson Card. There's a reason why the University of Texas has, you know, accepted his commitment, and he will sign with them. And as a Texas fan, I'm very, very excited about that. As a Westlake coach, it's a headache to have to defend him, but he is the one that has to be defended. You know, first and foremost, running game for them looks a lot like ours. It's been by committee, with up to three junior running backs, kind of like we are, and then. You know, wide receiver, you know, the two, Eves and Sandlin. I mean, they don't take a back seat to anyone that's played wide receiver for them in the 6 years I've been here. They look a lot like the guys who've come before them, and that's saying a lot.
Moments from now, Coach Dodge will give the pregame speech, and it's not going to be rah-rah. This is a game where you don't have to say much to your players.
I'm not worried about our players not playing hard. And not playing physical. I know they'll play really hard and they'll play really physical. I just, you know, it's our job as coaches is to lead them and put them in the best position to play well.
That's Westlake head coach Todd Dodge. When we come back, we'll sit down with Hank Carter, head coach of the Cavaliers. Lake Travis football continues in a moment.
Of Lake Travis football. Now they ask you to support another great Lake Travis program, the Cav Lounge. This program ensures that no student goes without the basics. Food, clothing, shoes, personal care items, school supplies, and even a snack or a prom dress. Every student is welcome, no exceptions. Visit facebook.com/Cav Lounge for more information on how you can help. And to get the 2019 campaign started, F2 OnSite is excited to donate $25 for every Cavalier touchdown this season. The Cav Lounge, the latest LT tradition.
My dentist told me I needed a crown, and I was like, I know, right?
Tired of waiting for that tooth to finally break down, fearing when and where? At Skybridge Dental, we can help you with that. We offer family-friendly dental services for all ages. From teeth cleaning to dental implants, we can take care of it all. Call us today at 512-402-9090 or visit our website at skyridgedental.com for more information. Call Skybridge Dental for all your dental needs. 512-402-9090. Next to Pete Terry's and Lake Travis High School.
In need of a private office space? Firm Space is an upscale professional workplace catering to business professionals who want a luxury work environment. Firm Space wants to make your workday easier by providing five-star hospitality, all-inclusive memberships, and an amazing community to network. Located at 500 West 2nd Street, Firm Space offers a prime downtown location, top-of-the-line design, amenities, and the best views in Austin. Schedule your tour today at firmspace.com and see how we can upgrade your office. firmspace.com.
Live on the highest elevation in Lakeway. With luxury homes starting at $600,000, Serene Hills offers hill country views without the commute. Our community is surrounded by 342 acres of unspoiled Texas wildlife. Residents have access to Lake Travis schools, miles of hike and bike trails, and kid-friendly parks. Serene Hills is the place where your dream home will become reality. For more information on how to get out of the city and into the hills, visit serene-hills.com.
Schedule a tour of your dream hill country home today.
Coach of the Lake Travis Cavaliers, and just another game for you, right? I mean, the inside track to the district championship, biggest rivalry that you guys have. I mean, what's going through your head right now?
Yeah, I'm ready to play some football, ready to watch some boys get after it. This is what an awesome atmosphere it's going to be. Sold out stadium, got a little chill in the air. This is why you play football, it's why you coach it.
It's a little breezy down here. I think I know your answer to this already, but with the colder weather and a little bit of a breeze, is that going to affect the game at all?
Yeah, wind can affect it more than anything. I mean, it's not cold enough for the air temperature to have an effect on it, but the wind's a little bit gusty. That can have an effect on the throwing, can have a big effect on the kicking game and handling kicks, things like that.
You dominated the series for 10 straight games, and the last two have gone the other way. Has there been a common theme in the last two games?
I really think the common theme was, especially last year, they blocked our defensive front. We didn't handle their defensive front. And the year before, there's some plays in there. I mean, that was a touch and go game. But last year, they really blocked us, and we couldn't block them, and that was a big difference.
Both teams average over 295 yards passing per game. Is it safe to say that the team that runs the ball better tonight is going to win the game?
To me, it always comes down to explosive plays and turnovers, but, you know, we need to be able to run the football. I think that we're running the ball as good as we have in a long time, and I think that we're doing it in such a way where it's a physical attack. We can chew it up, and we can move the ball and run the clock and keep the opponent off the field. That being said, these guys can run it. Their quarterbacks can run it. They can throw it. They're a good team.
So what do you need to do to get the W?
We need to have more explosive plays than them. We need to be able to make sure that they're one-dimensional. We can't let them have third and twos all night. And we need to be able to be balanced with our offense. We need to be able to be effective running the ball and then take some shots when we get a chance.
If you win the toss, you want the ball?
We'll probably defer. We normally defer every game. I actually haven't thought about it. We'll typically defer. But it doesn't matter. Everybody gets it the same number of times.
All right. Good luck tonight.
Thank you.
Hank Carter, head coach of the Cavaliers, back to the starting lineups and the kick when Lake Travis football continues in a moment.
Wouldn't it be great if your summer travels came with a guide? One that points you to the best beaches and shops? Well, while we can't navigate your vacation, when it comes to buying or selling your car, True Car is your definitive guide. Need a new ride? True Car shows you what other people paid for the car you want. Got a ride you want to sell or trade in? Get a cash offer in minutes from home. Just in 2018, True Car users saved $1.697 billion off MSRP across the country. So when you're ready to discover, buy, or sell your next car, visit True Car.
If you're thinking about buying a golf cart or perhaps looking to build a custom golf cart, check out the great folks at Golf Cart Zone. Maybe you already have a golf cart and need repairs or want to customize your cart. Golf Cart Zone is the place to go. New or used, buy or lease, riding on cart paths or through rough terrain. Make sure your search starts and ends with Golf Cart Zone. They even have a pickup and delivery service. Located on Research Boulevard between Spicewood Springs and Anderson Mill, reach them by phone at 512-258-9663 or online at golfcartzone.com. Every football team needs specialists. Those players that focus on one area to help the larger team. The same is true in healthcare. As hospitals and clinics struggle to remain profitable, specialists like Obsequio Ventures are providing that extra hand to ensure growth and efficiency. Whether the challenge is compliance, diagnostics, or legal, Obsequio Ventures can help healthcare facilities strategize and succeed. Obsequio is excited to be bringing their services into the Texas market very soon. Obsequio Ventures, a proud supporter of the Lake Travis Cavaliers.
And welcome back to Cavalier Stadium. As we get ready for kickoff, Cavaliers will receive. Westlake won the toss and deferred. Lake Travis wearing black jerseys with white numerals, black pants with a white and red stripe down the side, and the black helmets with the LT in red. The Westlake Chaparrals, undefeated. They come into Cavalier Stadium, white jerseys, royal blue numerals, royal blue pants, and silver helmets. We're glad you're with us tonight.